Hey guys, KR Rao this side and welcome to Creatrix YouTube channel. As promised, I'm trying to deliver the interview questions, which are very beautiful interview questions in this particular Creatrix channel. Anyway, by end of this session, you will get the clarity about transformer. Kind of one of the BARC interview question I'm going to consider, BARC interview question, and you would enjoy it for sure. And before sharing anything else, let me share about myself. I'm KN Rao. And one more thing is, try to subscribe to our YouTube channel. That is Gate Conqueror. You will get beautiful, very good content. Anyway, I'm KN Rao. I completed by Gate 2021. I completed 20 years of teaching for Gate IAC aspirants. And subjects, machines, networks, and power systems, I will try to plan to take. And just like this session, subscribe to our channel, okay? And if you want to make me more responsible towards your preparation, if you want to make me part of your preparation, use my code KRMR10. And here in Unacademy, there are two kinds of platforms, paid platforms. One is Plus and another one is Iconic. In Plus, you are going to get live classes, crash courses, rank improvement batches and all. And in Iconic subscription, which is bigger, superset. In Iconic subscription, personal coach will be there. That personal coach will, what they say, assist you in your preparation, who is an achiever of your age limit. And study planner, study booster sessions, personalized test analysis, and also study material they are going to provide in Iconic subscription. And coming to Plus subscription, for 12 month subscription, by using my code KNR10, 27,225 you have to pay. And for 18 months, it is going to be 34,650. And for 24 months, it is 39,600. And no cash EMI facilities also there, okay? And here for Iconic subscription, 40,500. And for 1 year and for 2 years, it is 54,000 rupees. And they thought of increasing fee structure from July 1st onwards, but they postponed the decision because of the huge demand from the student community. At any point of time, they may have to increase the fee structure. If you want to subscribe, subscribe soon to the paid platform. And they're starting Spark Batch and Ware Batch only for English speaking. And Spark Batch is meant for Gate 2022 and Ware Batch is meant for Gate 2023. In this, I'm going to start electrical machines in this particular batch. And I hope I'll be able to, I'm about to start the session from 16th of July this month. Okay, I'm planning. Now, if you see all of the very good faculties, most of them, almost all of them worked with me previously. And there are two more batches in English or Hindi. That is Lakshya Batch or Arohan Batch. Lakshya Batch is meant for Gate IAC 2022 and Arohan Batch is meant for 2023. Obviously, topmost faculties are there like BVR Reception and it's Angil Goel sir, everyone. And this is, they are conducting online tests also for paid platform. And test series will be Accelerate, Elevate, Excel, Accord like that. They are conducting OTS also, online test series also. And here, if you want to follow me at @ KN Rao Rao number 4U, such that you will get the notifications and all whenever I come to live, either in special classes or Plus classes. Now, let us see what is the question will be and how they will extend the question, we should know. Okay, this is actually BARC interview question. And in this, they will start with very small thing. And after that, they will develop the question. Let us see. Basically, this particular question, if you see, this particular question, kind of basic question is there in one of the civil services paper. From there, they develop this question. Just a moment. Let us think of this as transformer. Okay. And this transformer, let me have windings on both sides. Windings. Let me connect ideal voltage source here. Ideal AC voltage source here. And for this, they will ask, if some part of the, this is magnetic core, right? Why we are using magnetic core and all, it's a different deal, like gradually in our machine sessions we will see. But out of this magnetic core, if they remove some part of the magnetic material, okay, so that magnetic material, they are going to remove this particular material and remaining they are going to keep it as it is. in that condition, they will ask about what will happen to the operating flux, what will happen to the no load current. Okay, let me write here. They will ask about what will happen to the operating flux, and then means they will extend the moment. If you say because of this what they say non-magnetic material, if you say that flux is going to be reduced or increased, then they will not ask any further questions. Okay, means once you say it is going to be constant flux only, then only they are going to ask the remaining things. Anyway, operating flux they will ask, and no load current magnitude they will ask, and about hysteresis losses they will ask, and after that about eddy current losses they will ask, and they will ask you to draw the phasor diagram for that. Okay, they will ask phasor diagram they will ask, and they will ask about leakage, how leakage is going to be varied because of this. Okay, about leakage, as of now we may not be able to discuss much because we should know some basics of leakage in order to understand that, but remaining all will be able to understand. Okay, now let us think of one by one. Operating flux. Okay, magnitude of operating flux, means operating flux here, is it going to be increased or reduced or same? It will be same. Because if I think of, see here, magnitude of this particular voltage is V1, voltage source. So back EMF should be there, no? E1. Okay, now means the moment it is ideal voltage source, and if I think of this transformer as ideal, okay, ideal voltage source, transformer is ideal, V1 magnitude should be equal to E1 magnitude, right? Okay, if it is 100 volts, it should be 100 volts. If it is 50 volts, it should be 50 volts, because there is no other element connected in between V1 and E1. Okay, now means what is magnitude of V1 should be equal to E1 magnitude. Okay, and there is a confusion here. E1 equal to n d pi by dt or minus n d pi by dt. Coincidentally, both are right. Okay, I'll discuss about that point. That's why I have taken magnitudes. Okay, such that you need not question me whether to use plus or minus. Okay, n1 d pi naught by dt. Now, if I think of V1 equal to 100 volts at one initial, means E1 also should be 100 volts only. Now, see here. If I remove some part of the magnetic material, or if I have complete magnetic material, starting complete magnetic material will be there. In the second case, they are going to remove part of the magnetic material. Getting my point, right? Then, will there be any variation of V1? No. They are varying the magnetic material part, but they are not going to touch the V1 part. The moment they are not touching V1, E1 cannot be touched. Meaning that operating flux cannot be touched. Okay, so if you keep magnetic material or if you don't keep magnetic material, operating flux is not going to change. So which is going to be constant? Okay, now second thing is, they will ask about no load current. Okay, so the moment they ask no load current, let us convert this into, means analogous reluctance, okay, reluctance form. Okay, analogous electrical circuit for magnetic circuit, reluctance form. So if you convert this into reluctance, let me reduce this. Okay, reluctance. See here, from here to here, magnetic material reluctance. From here to here, non-magnetic material reluctance. So this is reluctance of the core. Okay, at starting without adding this. And this is going to be the MMF. This is going to be the MMF, which is nothing but N into no load current. Because secondary is not loaded. Machines, I'll tell you, until and unless they give you information, we have to assume that it is ideal. They did not give any information about no load current, meaning that we have to assume it as no load. That's it. Okay. Now, when I have total magnetic material, this is going to be the reluctance of the core, and operating flux is something. Now, if you see this particular non-magnetic material, they are going to fill this particular area with non-magnetic material. Obviously, non-magnetic material reluctance will be more. So, let me add some more reluctance of non-magnetic material. Okay, in the second case. First case, black, second case red. So I added some reluctance for the non-magnetic material. Now then, what is operating flux? Operating flux to remain constant. Operating flux to remain constant between first case and second case, operating flux is constant. Reluctance is increased, meaning that my MMF requirement has to be increased. The MMF requirement has to be increased. And if you see number of turns, did they give any information saying that number of turns here increased or decreased? No, they did not give any information. So we have to assume that number of turns is constant. The moment number of turns are constant, how to improve, increase MMF? No load current. No load current will be shooting. Okay. So see here, no load current has to be increased. No load current has to be increased. No load current has to be increased. Okay. Operating flux. Okay, let me. This is better. Okay. No load current is going to be increased. Now, let us extend this particular discussion to hysteresis loss. Okay. Now, if we see hysteresis loss, will it increase or reduce or same? Then people mindset will be like this. Okay. If it is something else is going to be included here, hysteresis loss should be increased. No, no. See here, hysteresis loss will be there only for magnetic material. For non-magnetic metal, hysteresis loss will not be there. For copper, hysteresis losses will not be there. Maybe for wood, hysteresis losses will not be there. Maybe for this, it is non-magnetic material. The moment it is non-magnetic material, hysteresis losses will not be there, because hysteresis form. Hysteresis form for non-magnetic material is going to be straight line. But if you think of for magnetic material, some kind of loop will be formed. In magnetic metal, some kind of loop will be formed. Means that particular area of BH loop is going to give the indication about hysteresis loss. But the moment it's non-magnetic metal, it's a straight line. So you don't get hysteresis loss. Now, see here, let's come back to here. In the first case, means between first case and second case, is there any variation of operating flux? No, operating flux is not varied. But see here, operating flux magnitude is same. Now, in the first case, throughout the core hysteresis losses will be there. But in the second case, this is non-magnetic material. The moment it's non-magnetic metal, in this particular volume of non-magnetic metal, meter cube, volume of the particular non-magnetic metal, you don't get hysteresis loss. But in remaining volume of the core, you are going to get, as usual, previous hysteresis loss. Okay. Now, the moment volume of the core, at starting volume of the core is full. But now after the change, volume of the core material, iron core metal is reduced. What does it mean? Hysteresis losses will be reduced. Okay. Now let me think of hysteresis losses. Hysteresis losses are supposed to be reduced. Why it is reduced? Because there will be no hysteresis loss. Hysteresis loss in non-magnetic material. Now, let us see how you are going to think about eddy current loss. Okay. Now let us think of eddy current loss. This is fourth one, right? Eddy current loss, are they going to increase or decrease or same? Maybe by the same analysis of here, you might think that hysteresis losses are reduced because it's non-magnetic material. So eddy current loss also should be reduced. No. Because, see here, they said that it's non-magnetic material, right? So this is non-magnetic material. But did they mention anything about electrical conductivity? Because, see here, all magnetic materials are electrical conductors. Iron is electrical conductor, that's it. Okay, but it does not mean that like all electrical conductors are magnetic materials. Because see here, if I think of insulation, for example, this is insulation, right? So the moment this is insulation, insulation is non-magnetic material. If you think of copper, electrical conductor, that is also non-magnetic material. Getting the point, right? So in non-magnetic material, electrical conductors also will be there, electrical insulators also will be there. Electrical conductors kind of copper. Okay, electrical conductors kind of copper. Okay, all very good electrical conductors are non-magnetic materials. Means silver is also non-magnetic material, and aluminum is also non-magnetic material. Okay, or if you think of electrical insulation, electrical insulators, kind of anything, rubber. Now let us observe. Our focus is eddy current losses, right? Eddy current losses will be coming into picture because of magnetic material, non-magnetic material, or electrical conductor, or electrical insulator. Depending upon the electrical conductivity, eddy current losses are going to happen. Eddy current losses are going to happen. Now, they said that it's non-magnetic material. Okay, they said that it's non-magnetic material, but they did not tell you whether it is electrical conductor, because this particular volume of core, I can fill this with copper. Electrical conductor, non-magnetic material. Or they can fill with air, rubber. That is electrical insulator, non-magnetic material. Now, you have to ask them. Because about history, eddy current loss, we cannot comment. About eddy current loss, we cannot comment. Impossible. For example, if they say that it is filled with non-magnetic material, electrical insulator. The moment electrical insulator, eddy current losses will not happen. Then I can say, well, my eddy current loss is going to reduce. Eddy current loss are going to reduce, provided if that filled non-magnetic material is electrical insulator. Okay? If that particular filled material is electrical insulator. Okay? Now, if it is electrical conductor, kind of copper or silver or whatever it may be, if you fill that particular part, if you fill this particular part with electrical conductor, we cannot comment. Why? Because eddy current losses will be decided by thickness of lamination, resistivity of the material and all. And they did not give you about the thickness of laminations of this particular electrical conductor non-magnetic material. Okay, and they have to give the resistivity of this particular non-magnetic material. So essentially, means this particular thinking process is going to be very complex. Okay, because we have to see the resistivity of the iron and the resistivity of the means filled material, electrical conductor, and we have to know the thickness of laminations here and thickness of laminations here. Then only we can comment. Okay, so can't comment. It can increase or it can decrease, or it can be same also. Okay. About the leakage. About the leakage, tell them that it is going to be increased. How it is getting increased and all, we will see in our regular sessions of welding transfer. Then you will understand about leakage properly. Okay. Now, we have to draw the phasor diagram. Right. Now, see here. This is operating flux. Phasor diagram. If you can draw the phasor diagram, or try to visualize how phasor diagram should be. Okay. If you can, understand, because of these things, if you can understand that phasor diagram, modified phasor diagram can be like this. If you can view in your mind, you are perfect. Okay, anyway, this is operating flux. Okay, and this is minus E1 RV1. Okay, let us think of no load current. No load current is going to be like this. No load current will be leading the operating flux by angle something like that, or from V1 to I0, I can say that this is theta naught. Theta naught is going to be no load power factor angle, we say. Right? how this particular modified INR should be. Now let us see. First thing is operating flux, which is going to be constant, right? And second thing is magnitude of INR should be increased. And third thing is hysteresis losses has to be reduced. Okay. And fourth thing is eddy current losses. Eddy current losses we cannot comment. Until and unless you know that filled non-magnetic metal is electrical conductor or electrical insulator. For example, if it is electrical insulator, then only we got the confirmed conclusion. See here. If it is electrical conductor, can't comment. But if it is electrical insulator, then only we know the output. Okay. Let us think of electrical insulator only. Eddy current loss also is going to reduce, provided that filled material is electrical insulator. Okay. About the leakage, we need not bother because no load, we are actually analyzing the transformer at no load. Now, see here, no load current has to be increased. Right? No load current has to be increased. No load current magnitude has to be increased. Now, can I increase? Same way like this? By having the same theta naught? No. No. Then how to increase? Magnitude, we know. Magnitude has to be increased, we know. But see here, if you think of loss component, okay? Loss component. Because hysteresis loss are going to be reduced, eddy current loss are going to be reduced. So, this is going to be the last component of voltage, right? Let me explain this too. Yes, now you'll understand. Okay. So, this is the last component of the voltage, sorry, last component of the current of no load. So, let me think of this as IW. Okay. So, this is going to be last component. Now, hysteresis losses are reduced. Eddy current losses are reduced, meaning the total loss component has to be reduced. Loss component has to be reduced, but magnitude has to be increased. What does it mean? See here. See, this is the last component, right? Last component has to be reduced. Now see. Okay. So, this is going to be the new no load current. Such that for this, if you see, last component is less or not. Yes, for this is going to be last component. Okay, last component of current has to be reduced, but magnitude of current has to be increased. So, this is going to be the phasor diagram. I'll tell you one thing. In dealing with interviews, okay, we have to always promote them. We have to always provocate them to ask more questions in our known area. How to deal with it? Maybe in our remaining, like many upcoming sessions are going to come now. In those upcoming sessions, I will tell you basically how to deal with interviews and all. Okay. Till that point, thank you very much. And subscribe to our Gate Conqueror YouTube channel. Okay. And you will get very good content kind of this. Thank you guys.